everyone, welcome to Morning English. This is January.
Hello, everybody. This is Summer. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Hey Jen, 你知不知道铁公鸡怎么说？
An iron rooster?
No, 你想一下我们平常说铁公鸡是什么意思嘛？
小气鬼是吧
？Yeah,
this one I know. We can say a cheapskate. A cheapskate is someone who doesn't like to spend money.
Right, 铁公鸡啊，就是小气鬼，不能直接用这个 rooster 表示公鸡，而是用到这个单词 cheapskate, like he's a cheapskate.
对，我发现其实我们经常用动物来表示一类人。比如说铁公鸡啊，黑马什么的。
Yeah.
And I also noticed that it's the same in English. People use some phrases to refer a certain group of people.
对，在英文中也是这样，经常用动物来描述一类人。而且有时候啊，你会发现中英文的表达还是对应的。
对，但是显然铁公鸡不属于这一类。
Yeah, right. So how about today we talk about that?
Sure, 那我们今天呢就来聊一聊英文当中用来描述人物的一些表达，这些表达呢都跟动物相关。
OK, 那 Jen 你刚刚讲到了黑马，这个在英文中啊其实就是对应的，但这个黑我们不用 black, but we say dark, 然后马呢是 horse, so people say someone is a dark horse.
Right, it means the same.Someone who is clever or skillful in a way that no one knew or expected.
对，就是你不知道他会胜利，所以就是黑马。比如说他在比赛中意外地拿到了冠军，是一匹黑马，就可以说 he's a dark horse in the competition.
Yeah, we can also say something is a dark horse. For example, the movie is a dark horse for the award. 那这部电影拿奖了，那其实电影也可以是黑马。
嗯哼。讲到马 Jen, 你骑过马吗 Have you ridden a horse before?
Yeah, I have, and I love the feeling. It's so free.
Yeah, so free. 骑马虽然颠得慌，但是真的很自由。但是骑马的时候，马是不自由的，因为他们要上那个缰绳。Do you know how to say that?
Rein, right?
Yeah, rein. 这个单词和雨的那个 rein 读音是一样的，但元音字母其实不一样，它是 E, R-E-I-N.
对，这个骑马用的绳子 rein 还可以用来表示掌控、管控 the state of being in control or the leader of something.
对，所以呢也有个常见的习语，就是 give somebody free rein, 不给人牵这个绳子，其实就是说给他充分的自由，不加约束， to give somebody complete freedom.
对，像很多设计师在工作当中就需要有充分的自由，就可以说 designers are given free rein at work.
Right.Like, we're also given free rein for our podcasts.
So, we're running wild now.
还好还好，马呢比较 wild, 我们不够 wild. Alright, 那刚刚讲的是和马相关的，然后讲的动物还想到狼也有一个，比如我们会说孤狼，就是说这个人不社交，他是独来独往的。
Yeah, there's a similar phrase in English, a lone wolf, someone who doesn't mix socially with other people. Lone 这个单词呢就是独自的。Wolf 是狼的意思，所以中英文呢在这里也是对应的，孤狼就是 a lone wolf.
Right, 像有的商界大佬他们就不爱社交，就可以说 the business tycoon is a lone wolf.
Well, I'm definitely not a lone wolf.
No, you're a party animal. 你绝对不是孤狼，你是完全相反这个 party animal.
This is also a phrase, right?
Yeah, party animal, 它也是个习语啊。它叫做派对动物，其实就是说特别爱社交，很爱派对的人 ，like Jen who loves parties and socializing.
Yeah, I think I'm a party animal. When I come to my place tonight, my parents are not home, and we can have a party.
Now you're truly given the free rein. 你这就是真正的不受束缚。
那讲到这个狼，其实我还想到了一个表达 ，someone's bark is worse than his bite.
是不是因为出现这两个词 bark 就是狗叫，然后 bite 就是咬一口这个咬。
对，但其实狼的嚎叫是用这个单词 howl， 但是 bark 的这个习语呢其实会更常见一些，一个人的叫声比他咬一口更糟糕，那其实就是说这个人啊刀子嘴豆腐心。
Yeah, he might seem tough, but it's not really. 叫得很，但其实心非常软。His bark is worse than his bite.
I think Colin is a good example of this phrase. He looks tough and sometimes makes harsh comment, but on the inside, he's soft and kind.
Yeah, I think so. Colin's bark is worse than his bite.
Okay, Summer, 你还能想到哪些带动物单词的表达？
小白鼠。
Yeah, this one can be confusing because we don't say small white mouse, but guinea pig.
是啊，这个小白鼠就是用来做实验的嘛。其实这种老鼠类型是天竺鼠、豚鼠，它的英文名呢并不是 white mouse, 而是 guinea pig, G-U-I-N-E-A, 两个 E 的长音 guinea, guinea pig.
对，而且虽然这个表达里面有个 pig 这个单词呢，但实际上它跟猪没有任何关系。So, like I said, it's a bit confusing.
Right. 那比如在实验室里啊，一个人志愿去当这个实验对象，我们就可以直接说这个 guinea pig. Like, he volunteered to be a guinea pig in the experiment.
So, have you acted as a guinea pig before?
No. Alright, 讲到这个 guinea pig, 我就想到另一个和 pig 相关表达了。这个就是真的跟小猪相关了，不是老鼠。这个词组就是 to make a real pig of oneself.
To make a real pig of oneself, 就是把自己变成了一个真正的猪。
What does it mean? 你想，猪是不是吃很多？然后我平常自己吃多了也会说，哎呀，吃成了一只猪。所以这个表达就是说，吃多了， to eat too much.
I see. Then this phrase is very useful for me.Because just last night, I made a real pig of myself.
你昨晚就吃多了，对吧？
Yeah, I ate so much that I didn't even need to have lunch today.
悠着点。Okay, 那这个 make a real pig of myself, 就是肚子吃多了啊，肚子里食物太多。那还有一个习语啊， have butterflies in one's stomach.
Oh, this is a very common one. Butterflies 就是蝴蝶， stomach.是肚子，那它的直译呢就是肚子里面有蝴蝶在飞，那其实就是形容那种非常紧张的感觉。
So it means the feeling of being very nervous. Right. 像考试前，我觉得大家应该都有这种感觉，非常紧张。 Every time just before an exam, you would have butterflies in your stomach.
Or when you see your crush.
Yeah, right.
And it's not just one butterfly, but so many butterflies.
对，因为是很多蝴蝶飞，所以这个表达也要注意。Butterfly 用到它的复数 ，have butterflies in my stomach.
Okay, so I think today we've talked a lot of phrases about animals.
Right. 所以大家能看出来，英文中和这个动物相关的表达真的很多。所以呢，多留意，然后呢，多做笔记。
So that's all the time we have for today.
Welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Thank you so much for listening. This is Jen.
This is Summer. See you next time.
Bye. Bye.